Hello, welcome back to Change Your Mind, Change Your Life. I'm Dr. Christine Bradstreet. I'm a retired chiropractor, and today I run this channel to help people like you get out of chronic pain and overcome chronic symptoms by focusing on the mind-body connection or the neural circuit pathway. I have a topic today that might seem controversial, but I stand by it because it's backed up by years of data and science that prestigious universities have accumulated. This is not my personal opinion, this is what data says. Surgery for chronic pain is basically useless, expensive, and dangerous. How's that for a topic? And that's what we're going to cover today. Before I go any deeper, please hit the subscribe button so that you won't miss any future content. And when you subscribe to a YouTube channel like mine, it's like supporting my small business, but it doesn't cost you any money, and it allows me to continue to bring research and content to you to help you overcome pain, symptoms, and live your happiest, healthiest life. So I appreciate very much that you're here. Thank you. So what is going on? Surgery for chronic pain is useless, expensive, and dangerous. Why do so many people get it? Well, that's what we're going to cover today. So basically, there just is no good evidence that justifies surgery for chronic pain. That's a lot to process. Surgery for chronic pain is a classic example of overutilization of care. And I know this is hard to hear if you're having chronic pain and considering surgery. And this is not medical advice. Any decisions that you make are between you and your doctor, but I want you to hear what the data says, because that's how you make an informed decision, right? I get people in chronic pain are desperate for relief, because I was there for many, many years, even decades. Now, not too long ago, a study looked at 25 separate studies to see if surgery or other invasive type procedures were helpful in chronic pain. And here's what we found. They looked at surgeries for back pain, knee pain, abdominal pain, endometriosis, and something called biliary colic, which is basically a gallbladder attack, and angina. There was little evidence that surgery actually performed any better than what they call a sham surgery. In sham surgery, often the patient undergoes all the preparatory things leading up to surgery, including being put under an anesthetic and an incision in the skin, but no actual procedure beyond that was done. That's what sham surgery was. And this isn't even the first time that it's been proven or discussed that surgery for chronic pain does no better than pretend surgery. And the conclusion of the study is that the risks do not outweigh any very small chance of benefit of surgery for chronic pain. So why is it still happening? Why are people still undergoing surgery for chronic pain? Well, there's probably a lot of answers to that question. One being, people in chronic pain are desperate for a cure. You know, maybe the pain has disabled the person. Maybe the pain is leaving them depressed. Maybe they have tried everything else under the sun and surgery is a last effort. And of course, as long as there are surgeons who are willing to do surgery, it will continue to be offered to people. Now, patients want surgery, but unfortunately, they don't have the deep understanding of physiology or kinesiology, or in other words, how the body works and moves and functions. And without that knowledge, surgery seems to make sense. You know, if something is not working, go in and take it out, or if something is broken, go in and try to patch it back together. But the body is so much more nuanced than that, and oftentimes the reason for the surgery don't even make sense when you understand physiology and kinesiology. Often first-line doctors pass difficult chronic pain patients on to specialists because the frontline doctor just doesn't have anything to offer. So you get passed on to a specialist, and you know, a specialist has tools in their toolbox and they're going to offer you those tools, and sometimes they're not the best answer. And another thought I had is that Americans, and possibly in other countries as well, Americans tend to have a bigger is better attitude. So, you know, don't give me an aspirin when a prescription medicine. I could have that instead. And so, you know, we tend to be wowed by technology and fall in infatuation with the newest thing, thinking that it's better than simpler tried and true methods. And then at the end of the day, the methods that are proven to me the most helpful are the things that take hard work. Diet and exercise modifications, physical therapy, core strengthening, yoga, meditation, mental health counseling, and mindfulness, just to name a few. And maybe you've tried all those things too, but again, stick with this channel because we're going to be teaching you how to make little adjustments to your brain and its wiring to break the cycle that developed that's causing your chronic pain and symptoms. Remember, here at this channel, we're talking about neural circuit symptoms, mind-body symptoms. And I know your pain feels very real, and you probably still are not 100% convinced that the origin of your pain is in your brain. I felt all those same arguments, and I never truly got better until I addressed the mind-body component. So remember, as you're going through this chronic pain journey, the least effective methods to help you are the ones that do something to you. So while a massage or a chiropractic adjustment feel wonderful at the moment, that's something being done to you, very low effective rate. Surgery being done to you, very low effective rate. The things that help you the most are the things that you take action in, that you take control of your health, you make lifestyle changes, you work on your mindset, you work on your mind and your brain to make the changes to your neurology to overcome chronic pain. Like anything else, your health is an inside job. There's no magic bullet from the outside that you can put in it. It's going to come from you, my friend. And have that be empowering, because that means that you can get better, that you are in control of this. You're not on this path alone. Help is here. Keep coming back to keep learning how to rewire your brain to live your happiest, healthiest life. Before you go, if you found this video helpful, please like it, please drop a comment, and please share it with somebody else who you think can benefit from it. I'm Dr. Christine Bradstreet. Thanks again for coming to Change Your Mind, Change Your Life. I'll see you on the next video. All right, thanks for being here. Before you leave, please be sure to subscribe and hit the bell notification so you'll know when I go live or when a new video drops. And visit me at christinebradstreet.com. Love to y'all. Bye-bye. See you soon.